I went to the hospital to have a few tests. I'd been getting some niggling pains in the middle of my chest. Halfway through the angiogram, the doc said, "Sorry, mate, you're going to need a bypass. You'll have to stay in here and wait." So I was confined to a hospital bed till my name came up on the list. I had to have sponge baths and wipe downs. I wasn't even allowed out for a pee. The doc reckoned it had caused too much stress on me heart. He said, "Relax, make the most of it, it's not that hard." And the first couple of days were bearable. I was peeing in the bottle like a champion. And the wife came in for bath time, so that was a bit of fun. But there was one thing I'd wanted to put off for as long as I can. The day soon came for number twos in the dreaded bedpan. Now I suggested to the nurse, "Wouldn't it be easy if I sat in a commode?" She said, "No, it's doctor's orders. You've got to stay hooked up to these electrodes." "All right, let's get it over and done with. Pass it over here." The nurse left me to it and I waited for a plan to appear. Now the pan was about a foot in diameter and 2 inches deep. I looked at it with impending terror. As I weigh about 100 kilos, there wasn't much room for error. So I saddled up and sat there rocking on the bed. That young doc who said it'd be easy, he must have rocks in his head. I finally stopped swaying and let nature take its course. I'm getting the hang of this, or so I thought. But that was the easy part. The worst was yet to come. Have you ever sat in a bedpan and tried to wipe your bum? I looked down at the pristine white sheets with the paper in me hand. Now how can I get me hand in there without falling off the pan? So I gritted me teeth and in I went, but I felt something soft and warm. I'd filled it right up to the brim. I was buggered, I was gone. Then I started to panic. The bed started rocking, I was swearing, I was sweating. The mess, it was shocking. The more I tried to make amends, the worse it all became. Everything I touched became covered with stinky brown stains. I could feel me blood was boiling and anxiety was high. It was like riding a buck jumper with no pickup man in sight. And I thought of Murray Harton and his cowboy poem called Turdulence. But this cowboy couldn't stop farting. It was more a case of turdulence. The ECG and all the gadgets, they were flashing and pinging. It was like a bad dream. Sounded like I won a jackpot on a poker machine. But it wasn't Friday night down at the RSL. I was in the middle of some stinky brown hospital hell. In the end, I succumbed and I rang the nurse's bell. Sobbing like a baby, I slumped on the side of the bed. The indignity and embarrassment as the nurse had to clean me up. For a minute, I thought I was in a nursing home, just like me poor old mum. Needless to say, the next time I had to go, the nurse got me a commode. She'd had enough the first time. She didn't want a repeat episode. I think she would have preferred if I had a heart attack. At least she could deal with it. Can't say that I blame her. I wouldn't want to clean up all that shocking mess. And I wonder how those young cardio doctors with all their medical degrees would go perched upon a bedpan swaying in the breeze. They should make it part of their training. Make them sit for an exam and see how they like it. Make them wipe their own bum on top of a chock-a-block full bedpan.